Muy buenas a todos amigos, soy Black, ¿qué tal estáis? Y bienvenidos una vez más a mi canal. Hoy os voy a enseñar los 7 mejores clutches de CSGO. Para aquellas personas que no sepan qué es un clutch, es muy sencillo, es cuando ganas una ronda estando solo. Da igual el número de enemigos, si ganas la ronda es que te has hecho un clutch. Así que chicos, como os he comentado, es un top 7. La primera vez que hago esto, suelo hacer top 5. Lo que pasa es que he subido una miniatura y había gente que no estaba muy de acuerdo. Me decían, lo deberías hacer más extenso para que conozcan a otros jugadores. Así que finalmente lo he hecho. Así que espero que disfruten muchísimo del vídeo y vamos a ver los mejores clutches de CSGO. ¡Let's go! Puesto número 7, un jugador que muchísima gente no tenía en cuenta, pero que sus números lo avalan. Estamos hablando de Dupri. Os voy a decir los porcentajes de 1 para 1 y los clutches en total que se ha hecho cada jugador, ¿vale? En este caso, Dupri tiene un 61% de victorias cuando se trata de ganar un 1 para 1 y en total se ha hecho 326 clutches. Estoy hablando de partidos oficiales, así que espero que disfrutéis de sus jugadas.
And I eat my words, they're ready for it. Dupri 1 versus 3.
It's got the Molotov though, so you can throw that to the mouth of the ramp room or chuck it on the bomb for the post-plant situation. We'll see what he decides to do. Ooh. What a shot that is.
That is so amazing, Dupri! He tells that he's gone to decon, goes back in. He's got two and he knows exactly where Nico is. And he nails it! Holy hell, Dupri, the ace in the last map. And that
again. Second kill coming in and he takes down Denison. Dupri, he can't see a thing. They're right in front, defusing the bomb. The smoke, oh my god! Dupri taking two and falling back, going for the shot.
No way!
Dupri, you've got to be kidding me! Dupri winning the round! This time, I don't think it's going to work out. Getting the kill on Taco, but they just have to play this one safe. 3 versus 1. Gonna go and isolate a player who almost gets that. Just play it cool now.
Surely he's used up all of his good fortune in that previous round. 45 seconds left in this 1-on-3. He's gotta hope for a mistake. And he's found Coldzera. Still alive. Fur and Bolts trying to get together. This bomb is gonna get
Now they're gonna try and double push him. They don't have a kit currently picked up. That's a big problem. He gets another kill. Taken down. Boom!
Oh!
Again! And again and again, Dupri! Winning it for Astralis 11-4.
Puesto número 6, recomendación de Corean. Y es un jugador que a nivel actual es una pasada. O sea, a día de hoy es de los mejores jugadores que hay en el juego. Y es un clutcher que también hay que tener muy en cuenta. Estamos hablando de Crims, que a pesar de que tiene un menor porcentaje en 1 para 1, que estamos hablando de un 59%, se ha hecho muchísimo más clutches que Dupri. En este caso, 399, rozando las 400, los 400 clutches este jugador de Fnatic. Así que vamos a ver sus clutches.
Bit of control with the kill onto Golden. Crims at this stage is just hoping for the best. He's in a off angle, he's in a position you wouldn't necessarily expect him to be in, but it's very vulnerable. He can see Zipnix lands the instant headshot and is now going to try and use that newly found room and make it his own. Flash over, Glaive going to be peeking, and Crims has got himself the clutch.
Down, can find more. The op still scoped in and looking toward the jail. Bombs down though, up close, and Nitro gets him. Very low HP for Nitro, but against the op, no condition. Look at Crims though, on the entry from the backside, controlling that recoil. Two down already, make it 3 on Adren, and it's down to a 1-on-1. Baits out the bomb carrier. There's your, pardon me, the bomb plant. With that defuse, Daps gonna try and take this fight. He runs. Daps, that's the second time this match he goes for the peak. That was more than 5 seconds already. He runs the whole way. Not only does he telegram where he's coming, I mean, they're confused.
To be honest, though, that wasn't necessarily. Daps had
unhappy. Tried to go aggressive. Tried to rattle the shots through, but as you saw, MBK, he's going full on. He's just ready to pounce on through. And why would they slow down? There's the flash. That's going to catch Crims out. They're going to push on through. MBK gets one, but Crims with a spray down. He gets himself the triple. And Fnatic are not done yet.
Can you believe it? What a spray down that was. It looked like he had absolutely.
Puesto número 5, un jugador que veo que muchísima gente no tiene en consideración, pero es que sus números son una auténtica bestialidad. Estamos hablando de Neo, jugador de Virtus Pro. Evidentemente no están en su mejor momento, pero estamos hablando de toda la historia, ¿vale? 66% de victorias en 1 para 1 y 480 clutches se ha hecho esta mala bestia. Vais a flipar con sus clutches.
It all crumbles. Virtus Pro not at all making it work. It's up to Neo. And with a little bit of luck, he might end up in a one-on-one versus Forrest. That'd be perfect. There it is. Neo getting one more kill. He's looking for it. The two best players, and there it is. Neo picking up the quad kill. We just introduced
much longer, just on Neo, and he has four players to find and frag. There's one. There's a second one. And the fact that Rubino is low now makes this possible. He's actually on for the ace as well. So there's so many accolades that Neo could be picking up for himself. Can he get this? Yes, he can. He's going to get the fourth one. And now it's all on Rubino, who must be wondering what's happening, Neo. He clutches. Unbelievable. Dignitas.
Along with the bomb, Snack's going to be going down. What are we witnessing now? Neo, the last one left. You know, 1-on-4. Dignitas deciding it is not over yet. They want to fight and they want to continue to battle into overtime.
And VP were just sat in positions where no one was watching the fountain. Neo very nearly lands the second one. Will through the wall. And now with this smoke, he can get the bomb planted.
He has a Molotov, and I bet he would love to use it to buy time, but they've already smoked out the bomb. There's another headshot coming through. He'd have to go for the ace clutch into winning the semi-finals here, looking for another spray. Neo's going to get it. He goes for more. Spray for the one. He's out of bullets.
Puesto número 4, un jugador francés que me habéis recomendado encarecidamente que ponga en este top, me parece una mala bestia. De hecho, ahora mismo está lesionado de la muñeca, pero va a volver seguramente con un nuevo combinado francés. Estamos hablando de Sox, el exjugador de G2, que tiene un 65% de victorias 1 para 1, pero supera a Neo en clutches 496. Vais a ver que la barrera de los 500 va a ser superada por tan solo un jugador que de hecho va a ser el puesto número 1, así que vamos a ver sus jugadas.
Luminosity, they're not showing themselves, they're not giving them any opening. RPK pushing into the back and he goes down to Cold Zero. It's all on Shox. He picks up one and goes back for more. He has no grenades. Luminosity in overtime here looking for the shot. Shox gonna pick up one more. Triple for him. Oh, he gets the quad kill. Are you kidding me, Shoxy? He gets every single one and keeps the dream alive.
They've rotated over towards the B side as well, Fnatic, and they're getting that bomb plant down. Spots Olofmeister in B halls, and he knows there's a man on the site. He's looking for that kill first, but Twist barely bouncing out. This is unreal. One headshot. No way. Shoxy, he could do it. The 1v1 clutch. He's looking for one more shot. Five bullets left in the magazine. And Twist, he's trembling. Shoxy will get it. The kill. Unreal.
So, so they have to take these duels. And it's just Luminosity systematically shutting him down.
It was like trading places, right? All of a sudden, they're the terrorists trying to run up Cat. And you got the CT guy sitting by cars with the op. Follow was like, great. I'll take those shots all day.
Triple kill for Fallen, who has been carrying his team. He is the captain here, and he has been top fragging for a very long time here on Dust2. It's on Shox in a 1-on-3 to try and keep it alive. Otherwise, we'll go to a fifth map in the Grand Finals. Shox tabs out one, and that's a deadly kill. Goes for the second, and he's moving closer, looking for the quad clutch here. FNX, the last man alive. He's going to tap the bomb once. Shox
breaks.
You've got to be kidding. He takes the quad kill.
Puesto número 3, aquí va a empezar el salseo con este top, ¿vale? Pero considero que al final, de hecho había puesto este en el puesto número 1, pero bueno, lo he ordenado como he podido y creo que lo he hecho bien. Puesto número 3 para Simnes, el jugador de Astralis, desde mi punto de vista ahora mismo dentro de fuego es el más inteligente 1 para 1, como digo, es a día de hoy. 66,5% de victorias 1 para 1 y 470 clutches se ha hecho este jugador danés, así que vais a ver sus clutches.
Completely trucked by Shox and Apex gets a headshot. It's all on Sip. He's alone. He gets one. The bomb is right in front of him. He's clicking through the smoke and missing the last couple of shots. Body is on it with the defuse kit. He's gonna get one kill. Sip for the smoke. Oh my god, he picks it up and now running back in. He's got the quad and he's looking for the ace. No more bullets though. Nice.
Oh no.
Sipix with the ace. Are you kidding me? Taking down.
But it has left just Zipnix alive. And now we've been pressured. Actually crumbles Zipnix. All right, Clutch Master, let's see what you can do. Oh, Kyo's giving away a bit of the game here. And there it is, Zipnix. It's a lifeline, it's a window, and it's a thin one. But look at this gamble.
From Kiyoshima, you can't give this guy this much space to work with. One at the upper bomb site. He absolutely does. And there it is.
My God.
More magic from Zipnix. He's gonna get the plant, and it's Neko. He's fooled. He thinks it's gonna be the lower bomb site. He took the gamble to see if Zipnix would drop down vet.
Holds his nerve. He waits. He waits. The molly burns, and he now knows. Oh, Neko! He tries it, but nothing comes through. It's Zipnix from start to finish, when it looks impossible.
Again, he's gonna catch the bomb. This is unreal. The timing.
That is big. 1-on-3 for Sip, but he's got the bomb in 40 seconds. Zipnix. He's gonna be turning his back and down to one health. Bialy with the patience play coming out. Flashbang is in there now. 25 seconds. Headshot coming in from Sipnix. What could Bialy do? He has to find the angle here. This is not easy. Bialy way out in the open. He gets shot down. Sipnix with the 1-on-3 clutch. Oh my God. One health left.
Puesto número 2, el Master Clutch de CSGO, que muy Tom me lo ha recordado. Ahora mismo, evidentemente, NiP no está en su mejor momento, pero en la historia fue uno de los mejores jugadores del mundo. Y este, bueno, de hecho lo conocí en persona y me cayó súper bien, así que también hay cosas subjetivas. Getright, el jugador, como digo, de NiP, que tiene el mayor porcentaje de victorias 1-1, estamos hablando de un 68,5%. Imaginaros que 7 de cada 10 veces sale ganando, es una bestialidad. 493 clutches se ha hecho este jugador, vais a ver algunos de ellos.
He's got 2 kills out of this. A third as well. Bong does drop. It's a problem now entirely, but Pauf does have the AK, and Getright still limited to the CZ. 75 head shown. Pauf can't find the immediate shot. That's going to give Getright a bit of information. Goes back out. It's on 22 HP. Getright can do this. 3 kills already. Bomb in an awkward position. Pauf has to jump up, but Getright's got it. CZ 75, 4 kills, and Pronax makes the mistake of not planning immediately.
Go down. If that had been the old CZ, it would have been no issue at all. Getright trying to AWP. A 1v2 running up here with P250 out, jumping and shooting. He gets one more kill, looking for it. He's got him hunted down. Time is up. Oh my God, Garrett, are you gonna be kidding me? He gets the last kill in 1 second.
CS actually takes a bit of a bullet to the face there, and he's fighting it out with Scream. If Kaidrai coming in, there's MDK going down. That's a great start. Could have almost got the second shot, even if he was flashed. 2-on-4 situation, they're not giving up easily here. Existence is now the one.
Taken down Existence, but Scream did find one, but Getright still stands. Bringing it back into a 1v2, he's got Scream, he's got Shocked, he's got another! 1v1 now, he's already got 3 in the bag. Can he get forward to take his team into the second map? He's challenging down Scream, oh my God, the reload, 7 seconds left! Getright's done it!
Y por último, puesto número 1, el polaco, el que todo el mundo sabe que voy a poner en el puesto de campeón. Estamos hablando de Snax, jugador de Virtus Pro. Al igual que NiP, no está en su mejor momento, evidentemente, pero estamos hablando de toda la historia. Tiene un 64% de victorias en un 1-1. No es el mejor de todos, pero atención, que se ha hecho 501 clutches. Para mí, junto a Sipnix, le diría que a día de hoy son los mejores clutches que hay en el juego. Pero es que eso ya depende de vosotros y vuestra opinión. Como digo, vamos a ver las jugadas de esta medalla de oro.
Almost getting the kill there, double faced, and Snax will use that to at least get the bomb down. But he can take an angle towards the connected position as well. There's a
that noise entirely.
Yeah. Oh my God.
Dirty.
What on earth is that? That's crazy to get that angle.
That was like, I don't know what Leck was trying to accomplish in that angle though.
There's still a game to play here, and Snax in main. Snax looking for the no-scope. Ah, there it is! Stoplan had no idea where he was. Convinced he was in. Maybe he got back.
Does find one.
Oh, no.
Let's not leave him out of this. The Big Apple, and Snax is hungry. He's got 1 kill already on the USP. Low HP as well on Guardian and Flamey. He's trying to bait them out, trying to get them into one-on-ones as he dances back and forth between the box. What a shot on Simple! Oh, Guardian, bye-bye! And it's on to Flamey. He's tapped it. Flamey's got a big. What in God's name is that from Snax? Unbelievable! Caught by Guardian. You shall not sneak by and you shall not succeed in holding off the rotations. It's Snax that has to do so. 1v2. And Guardian still on that AWP. Snax with the same weaponry. But a close position from Edward is going to force him, funnel him out. But he finds the shot. A lovely shot at that of Guardian! And oh my God, Snax, have you ever just stolen it from Na'Vi?
Y hasta aquí el vídeo de hoy, espero que os haya gustado y quería deciros algo de corazón. Muchísimas gracias a todas aquellas personas que han comentado en Twitter y que me han abierto los ojos con algunos jugadores. Es cierto que algunas veces es complicado hacer tops porque te puede fanatismo, ¿no? En este caso a Sipnix lo había puesto en el puesto número 1 y a mí es mi favorito, pero a lo mejor no lo merece. Y es que quiero saber vuestra opinión en los comentarios. Para vosotros no voy a decir el top 7, ¿cuál es vuestro top 5 de mejores clutches de CSGO? Me encantaría verlo. Espero que lo votéis con un like a este vídeo de corazón porque es uno de los que más me han costado hasta la fecha, de corazón. Muchísimas gracias por, como digo, esos comentarios, muchísimas gracias por hacerme aprender más de CSGO y por vuestro apoyo. Nos vemos mañana con un nuevo vídeo. ¡Un saludo! Y hasta la próxima.